great political reform. People are seeking freedom. They want freedom, democracy. They want justice. They want real government that represents, and the president that represents the people. The nation should be really the source of power. That these statements should change to a real act and to a real position of the new authorities that will manage Egypt in this future. We are also facing security, lack of security, because when you follow the media, you can see the security forces, not the military forces, but the security forces, the Ministry of Interior Affairs, have been a part of the regime. They've been all the time, more than a million persons. They've been prepared to remain all the time against the people, not saving or sustaining the security of the people, but rather protecting the regime, Mubarak and his surroundings. And they've been all the time, they didn't represent the people, and they have been against them now. They somehow fled away and they left their positions. They are not there. Few of them are trying to come back. But the situation and security, as far as security is concerned, needs to be somehow reformed and reestablished with probably a new management in that direction. Economics also, as you know, since we have a great revolution, big movement, more than 15 million of Egyptians have been moving the streets on the Friday, 11th of February. That's a famous day. More than 15, some people said 20 million of Egyptians had been moving the streets, and they are insisting on what they want. Their gangs and others have been leading them all the time. Also, we talk about education. Education is the main purpose and goal that should be in front of all of us in Egypt, because education represents the backbone of development. When we want to talk about developing the country, we talk about not only politics, but also we talk about economics, we talk about other things. Education will represent the main source for these challenges. Health also, people of Egypt have been suffering from disease, and they are living in a very weak situation as far as health is concerned. Clashes between Christian and Muslim, this is a very minor act, but somehow it's been exaggerated and been shown as if we have a real problem. The counter-revolution now, we have few elements who are representing the counter-revolution, trying to pull Egypt and take it back again. Of course, they will not succeed, but they are trying. The people who've been belonging to Mubarak regime, who've been benefiting from that regime, those are trying strongly to somehow move undergrounds and collect others who are cooperating with them and benefiting also from them. They are not quite numerous, but they're having some power. They may have some effect on that movement. The members of also the security forces, more than 1,400 officers who've been controlling the country by those numerous number, I said that more than a million person who've been protecting Mubarak and the regime, been torturing the people and pressing them, revoking everything, and been using all means and kinds to prevent the Egyptians from voting in elections. Those are still there. Most of them are still there. They are behind the scene. They're trying to go back to the last scene and try to prevent this revolution from continuity or from continuing to reach its goals. They are very dangerous to the revolution, and they are still there. Also, among those elements, the remainders of the National Democratic Party, those who are who've been in that party, which wasn't a real party that didn't represent the people, but to some extent They are still there. The party has been dissolved by court statement, but its members are in the society. They are like viruses in the body, and they are doing their all kinds of efforts to be somehow effective in the future of Egypt. Also, unfortunately, we have some effects that coming from outside, foreign affairs and or foreign forces. You know, some people outside Egypt may not like what happened in Egypt. They are afraid. They think or believe wrongly, and I repeat wrongly, that Egypt in the new position, when the Egyptians are free, they will all the time boycott the international world and try to threaten the international peace and things like this, which are not completely correct. They are not correct. They are trying to push Egypt back and cooperate and collaborate with those internal forces somehow to make a front, trying to again affect the revolution and minimize its benefits and goals, and probably try to go back to the old regime, which is impossible now. The Arab world, well, you know, we have regimes in the Arab world who maybe they are not happy with what happened in Egypt. And we have now also great movements from people in Libya, in Yemen, in Syria. Probably it will happen in some other places. That represents to us a major and important thing, because, you know, the Arab world affects each other. The countries and the people are somehow having similar cultures. The Islamic world also is, Egypt is a part of that world, and it's affected by what's going on in Afghanistan or Pakistan or Iran or Turkey or even Indonesia. The North Africa countries also are not quite stable now. But USA is a separate factor, because USA, all the time the authorities in USA trying all the time to keep their hands and putting their umbrella all over the world, especially on the Arab world, and we can see that clearly. And they, well, some of them, probably the government, especially not the people, probably they are not happy for what happened, because when people become free and they have their own world in their hands and they can express themselves and they can develop themselves and become an important element in international politics and international society, that may not please them to, they think, as we can see, that this minimizes their benefits in the Middle East. They also being biased all the time towards Israel and its position against the Palestinians and the Arabs. And they think, like the Israelis do, that the revolution, the new era, the new regime in the Arab world or in Egypt, especially if it's an Islamic, then it will be against them, that we will fight them, which is not correct, of course. So USA representing to Egypt now, to the people in the area, well, I don't like to say that the American governments, the consecutive American governments, by their double standard positions, consider the people of that area like, enemies or something, which is not correct also. And the relationship with Europe must be a better one than before. And Europe also is affected to a great extent by USA positions in the Middle East. And we hope and we want and we are insisting on a good relationship with the outside world, with the international society, with the people in the international society, and with the governments if we can. Now, Egypt, in a narrow scale now, we are in a bottleneck situation. We are passing through the bottleneck now. This year is a very important year to us. During this year, we will have the parliament elections, the upper and lower chambers, and we will have the presidential election, probably by the end of the year or in the beginning of the next year, 2012. We will also have a committee that will be formed by the parliament for putting the new constitution for Egypt. Now, Egypt is in a situation that you can see what we have. We do not have a constitution, which is very bad. Our old constitution is not good, but it's even frozen. We are in a transitional 63 statements issued by the military council as a temporary constitution. We do not have a parliament, which is also bad, because a parliament is the backbone of a body that's supposed to be a big one, 85 million land history, position, and international distinguished relationships. We do not have a parliament now. We don't have a president. So we don't have a government, a well-settled government. It's a temporary situation. It's very sensitive. And we can see and hear every day what's going on. And so far, so good. And thanks God that the situation is not too bad. We've been expecting even worse, but it's going. And the people are now wise enough, mature enough to distinguish and see what's the difference between good and bad, between the old regime and the expected regime to be. They can select, they can go to poll stations, they can elect and be elected. I think we need the international society to understand the Egyptian people now. The people of Egypt now are considered one body. There are a few eddy currents here and there, but it's moving towards the goals. The goals of the Egyptian people are considered the leader of the people since the 25th of January up till now. The international society got to be more patient about the situation in Egypt and about the Islamic movement in Egypt, about our party, which is just, well, it will be born within a month or so. We have made our efforts and attempts to start as soon as we can, but it takes some time. According to the law, to the Egyptian law now of parties, now we are moving and going together, and we want, as I said, the people around us to help the Egyptian people to understand what's going on really in Egypt. And when I was invited to this lecture, I was very happy, and I didn't hesitate to come to discuss such matters tonight with you. If you have any questions, or if you want to add some advice or seek some sort of explanation of the position, I will be happy to make such a discussion. Thank you very much for your attendance, and I hope that we will benefit from this special meeting. Thank you.